Hey everyone, let's go over question 3 from the Compound Data 1 workshop. So with these questions, we are doing some operations on arrays. So we're learning more about what happens when we make calls like data.length and allocate the output to an integer called result, what happens when we do data1, data3, and all of that. So for each of these questions, we've got this array called data, which has the values 1, 7, 2, and 9. So I've already done that memory diagram over there on the right. So that will help us with each of our questions. So 3.1, result is being allocated the output of data.length. And it's tempting for questions like these to say that the answer is 3, because the last index we have here is 3. But when we're talking about length, we're talking about the number of items there are. And the number of items there are is 4. It's just because we're numbering them from 0 to 3 that can get a bit confusing. So when I'm saying data.length, that's equal to 4. So whenever you want to access the last item in an array, that index will always be data.length minus 1. Because we start counting from 0, that last index will be 1 less than the length. So this will be really helpful whenever you're trying to access the last item of an array that you don't know the length of. Awesome. So for 3.1, result will be equal to 4. What about this next one? We have result is equal to data1 plus data3. Again, it's tempting here to say that we're getting the first item and the third item, but in this case, we're talking about the indexes. So we're looking, at least for this one here, data1 is referring to the item in data at index 1. So not the first item, the item at index 1. And that there is 7. So data1 is 7 plus data3, which is 9. So 7 plus 9, and you get 16. So you should have gotten 16 for 3.2. Cool. 3.3, you've got result is equal to data, and its index is data.length minus 1. And we already said that data.length minus 1 is always the last index in an array. So if we have a look here, data.length is 3. Oh, sorry, data.length is 4, minus 1, and you get 3. So we're accessing the item at data3, and that value is 9. So data is the same as data 4 minus 1, which is data 3, and data 3 is 9. Awesome. When we get to question 3.4, we've got a loop as part of our answer. And this is quite a generic loop that you'll see with a lot of compound data questions, or a lot of array questions, because what this loop is doing is it's going through every single item in an array, where the loop variable is representing the current index. So we know that when we have an array, we always start our indexes at 0, and that continues on until we get to data.length minus 1. But here we've said I is less than data.length, so it will never equal data.length, which is exactly what we want it to do. So let's use a loop logic table to answer this question. Just make this a little smaller. So what do we need to keep track of? We need to keep track of I. We need to keep track of our condition, which is I is less than data.length. Data.length is 4, so I'm just going to write data is less than 4. And we want to know the value of result at the end. So that's my table there. Sorry, it's a bit small. And we've got result is equal to 0 initially, and I is equal to 0. Our condition is I less than 4? 0 is less than 4 is true. So what are we doing inside our loop? Result plus equals data I. So we're adding data 0 onto result. Data 0, so that's the item at index 0, which is 1. So we're plussing 1 here. And then we get to the end of our loop, so we increment I. So I is equal to 1 now. We check our condition, is 1 less than 4? Yes. Result was previously 1, and now we're doing result plus equals data I. I is 1, so we're accessing the item at 1 in data, index 1. So that item is 7, so we're plussing 7. And we get 8. Again, we increment I. Is 2 less than 4? Yes. Result is 8. Result plus equals data I. So result plus equals data 2. What's data 2? Its value is 2. Increment I again. Is 3 less than 4? Yes. Result was 10. Result plus equals data I. So data 3. And data 3. Is 9. Then we can't forget this step. I is now equal to 4. We've updated I. Is 4 less than 4? No. So when we get to the end of our loop, result is equal to 19. And what this loop has done is it's gone through every single item in our array and added the value of each item to result. So what this code is doing is just adding up all the items in our array. So that's something that you'll probably do in exams and maybe in assessments. It's quite useful. And then 3.5, we've got a different style question. So I'll just zoom back in on my array here. It's the same array. We've got the same loop. So we know looking at this loop that I is representing the index, and so we are going through each item in our array. And so for each item in our array, we're taking that item and we're multiplying it by 2. So if we do that with I is equal to 0, we've got data 0 is equal to data 0 times 2. So that's updating the value. So data 0, which is here, is no longer 1, it's 1 times 2. Which is 2. For data 1, which is the next one, so data 1 is equal to data 1 times 2. Data 1 we said was equal to 7, so I can fill that in. Data 1 is equal to 7 times 2. So we get 14. And again, this loop goes through each item, so we're performing that update on each item inside data. And that's the array that you'll have in the end there. And that's how you do all the questions from question 3.